That the best of my knowledge and recollection, all illegal drug-related matters outside PCC's jurisdiction were referred to these agencies. That outside from my previous official position in the PCC, the only involvement that I personally had with respect to that illegal drug campaign of the president, of the government, I'm sorry, before and after President Duterte is in my personal capacity as a minister of the gospel and founding chairman of the Yeshua Change Agents Organization.
I will let you finish the paragraph. Sige, just continue.
Through the YCA, I have helped and continue to help in the demand reduction program of the government by helping in the prevention campaign of those at risk of illegal drug use, as well as the rehabilitation and recovering of former drug dependents.
Okay. Thank you, sir. Thank you. I have a copy of your affidavit then. Salamat po. Thank you. So now we will commence with our questioning by the senators. Upon the request of Senator Bato de la Rosa, is there a Colonel Grijaldo here? Colonel Grijaldo, upo po kayo dito kasama namin. Well, Senator de la Rosa will be the one to introduce him maybe when he asks questions too, directed to Colonel Grijaldo. Okay, so, pursuant to our guidelines, we will now commence the questioning. We will have to start with our Senate officers. So I now recognize Senator Jingoy Estrada. You have 10 minutes, sir. 10 minutes. Thank you.
Thank you, Mr. Chair. Some questions addressed to the former president. Mr. President, kanina pa ko kayo tingin na tingin sa amin, hindi kayo lagi kayo tumitingin sa kanan, hindi ko kayo tumitingin sa kaliwa. Nagpapansinan na ba kayo ni Senator De Lima?
Wala maganda dyan, dito lang.
Anyway.
Mr. Chair.
To be serious,
yes, Mr. Chair, I beg the SP Pro Tempore to lead us in setting the tone that this is not a laughing matter.
I was not joking.
I was just para ma-lighten lang yung mood, Mr. Chair. Anyway, on a serious note,
yes, okay.
Mr. But President, how do you assess the
virulent ailment that the country is facing? It's panahon ko and the presidents. Yung panahon ko, hindi siguro ninyo nagustuhan, not you, yung the entire country, I'm addressing the entire country. Baka hindi ninyo nagustuhan. But yun ang style ko. Sinabi ko nga, I tried to do the best that I could. Eh kung nagkulang ako, pasensya. Pero ang solution during my time was a call of duty of the president. Ako yun. Kasi ako yung presidente sa panahon ko. At hindi po ako nagkulang, Mr. Senator. Nag-warning ako lahat narinig ng Pilipinas. Huminto kayo sa droga, bitawan ninyo, drop it. Kasi magkakaproblema talaga tayo. Pag nakita tayo sa isang kanto at nahawak mo ang droga, problema na talaga yan. So, yun na, nagkakaroon tayo ng problema. May patayan. But it was not a state-sponsored killing. There was never an official order to the police and the military and to the agents of government to kill. Andiyan si Senator De La Rosa. Wala akong sinabi na ganun kasi abogado ako. Ang sinabi ko, yung sinabi ko noong nagtuturo ako sa Police Academy, that in your fulfillment of duty, yung elements of self-defense would apply to you pag you are trying to arrest a person. Alam mo, ang trabaho ng pulis kasi, pag sinabi mong aarestuhin kita, hindi hinto dyan. The police must arrest and overcome the resistance para madala mo yung kriminal doon sa istasyon at mabok mo para makulong. Yan ang problema at naawa ako sa mga pulis. Hindi mo masabi, bitawan mo yung baril at pag hindi sumunod, sabihin lang ng pulis, o sige, bukas makita tayo dito, huwag ka nang magdala ng baril. Po, hindi yun ang tinuro ako sa kanila, nagtuturo ako sa Police Academy, yan lahat yan sila dumaan sa akin.